All right. I just want to share just a short message, not a long message. And it's from the Word of God. And it's really important. I just want to remind you that a pastor that loves people will always give them the Word of God. It's really important that you guys understand that and the Word of God is what we need right now. We need it to cling to it. We need a hope in it. We need it to give us strength inside of our soul right now. These are peril times. There's so much that's going on. So I just want to share with you guys just a short message and just a reminder tonight about God's love. And the title of this message is God is Love. And so this is 1 John 4:7. If you have your Bible, you could turn with me there. And if not, just listen. But 1 John 4:7 says, beloved, that word beloved, it means that you're dearly loved. You know that? It says, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. And he who does not love does not know God, for God is love. And so I just want to remind you this evening that God's very essence is love. It's who God's character is. And when we love one another, we are actually fulfilling God's most fundamental wish for our lives. It is God's desire that you and I, that we would love one another. And I just want to encourage you, if you're listening tonight, I just want to let you know that the Lord, he loves you more than you can ever know. And man, he loves you so much. And 1 John 4:9 says this, and this, the love of God was manifested toward us. So in this, the love of God, that word manifested means revealed. So the love of God was revealed toward us in this, that God sent his only begotten Son into this world that we might live through him. And this is love. So this is actually what we know what love is. It's not that we loved God. Matter of fact, the book of Isaiah tells us that we all, like sheep, have gone astray, that every single one of us turned to our own way. But you know what happened? Is that all of our sin was laid upon the shoulders of Jesus Christ, because he loves you so very much, and he loves me so very, very much. I heard someone say that if you're the only person on this earth that he would have died for, he still would have died for you. And how do we know what love is? It's that God loved us and he sent his only son to be the propitiation or the sacrifice for our sin. God, the Lord Jesus, took our place on the cross and he loves you. And I just want to encourage you tonight to remain in God's love, to abide in God's love, to rest in God's love, to let God's love be your strength and your banner. 1 Chronicles 6:14 says this, and he said, Lord God of Israel, there is no God in heaven or on earth like you, who keeps your covenant and your mercy and love. See, God is a covenant-keeping God, and God wants to keep his covenant. He wants to keep his promise to you and his promise to me. You know what the Bible says? That God made a covenant with the whole entire world. Do you know that? He made a promise to this whole entire world that he will not change his mind or break. And it says in the Bible, for God so loved you, and for God so loved me, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, no matter what creed, no matter what background, no matter what nationality, no matter whether we're poor or rich, that whosoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world. That's important, because the message is not condemnation, but the message is salvation. Remember that this world is already condemned. We're doing this to ourselves. We're in such a destitute place, and we desperately need God. And so the Bible says that God so loved you that he gave his only begotten son. And Psalms 36:7 says this, how precious is your loving kindness, O God. Therefore, the children of men put their trust under the shadow of their wings. And so I just want to play a song tonight, not a long song. And I just want to encourage you to come under the shadow of God's wing tonight, to come under the shadow of Jesus Christ. To let him love you tonight. Can you guys hear that guitar okay?
Yeah, amen.
Just let him love you tonight. Just rest in that love tonight. Yes, yes. Let him fill you tonight. Just let him hold you tonight. I know there's craziness right now, and there's chaos, and everything is going on, but I just want to encourage you just to stay under that shadow. He won't break his covenant. He won't break his promise. He does so love this world. He does so love his creation. And he is here tonight for you. And he is here tonight for me. And he wants us to remain in that love. So let's love one another. Amen. Let's love one another as we run into our go to the store and run into everyday life. Let's just love one another right now. I know there's a lot of hate going on. Amen. There's a lot of discontent going on. Let's just love one another right now and let our light shine. Amen. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb. Wash me in the blood of Jesus. The Lord washes tonight. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb. Wash me in the blood of Jesus. Amen. I want to thank you so much, Red, for letting me share. And thank you so much, Brad, and for all that you guys do. Just keep letting your light shine. Amen. Love you guys. Thank you.